Are you ready?
Yeah.
Set?
Yeah.
Go.
Hey everyone, I'm a programmer. How many of you guys are programmers? Hands, come on, hands. That's a good ratio. So my presentation is a bit technical, but I feel it's quite important. It's about things which we do in our game code, you know, and pretty much, you know, damage it, but things we can optimize and do better to improve it. So I have 7 points, the 7 sins of Android game developers, and let's get into them. So number one, Android mobile in general is pretty much just like PC and console. So many lessons we have learned and they still apply. So there's a lot of common knowledge out there and we should use it more in our game. And a lot of what's coming is examples. So let's take this code, for example. We have 2 methods. They're pretty much the same. We are iterating an array, but by one time we are incrementing by 1 and the other time we are incrementing by 16. So it's pretty much the same, no tricks, right? So what happens? You'd expect for performance, it will be exactly the same. So I've put it into a benchmark, and the results are quite astonishing. When you look at the graph, you see that it's just about 5 times slower when you increment the data by 16 bytes at a time. What's going on here? So beyond the software, we also have our hardware. We have our CPU and the cache. And when you want to send data to be transformed in the cache, it needs to be laid out in a way so it can read it. If the cache doesn't have the data, you get a cache miss, and it needs to be copied into it. So that can literally double or times 5 your performance. And then the end lesson is that when you're making your code, you really need to think about your data. So make design for the many, not the one. You always have a lot of physics objects, not just one. Okay, number 3, thy shall not abuse thy draw calls. We want to make a huge army, a crowd, a forest, or, you know, just a nice field of grass, maybe. And for doing that, we have a lot of draw calls. But when we do it, you know, we need to send a command to the GPU. So we need to sync with another thread and with the hardware, we communicate with the drivers, and we waste our CPU cycles. And then we do it again and again and again, and we're not really doing any good work. To fix that, there is a technique called geometry instancing. This is available from OpenGL ES 3. So we have our mesh data on one buffer and the per instance data on another. That's the worldview projection and the color. Then we draw a lot of objects at once with just one draw call. Next, do not decompress on the CPU. We have PNG and we have JPEG and WebP, and we really want to use them to lower our upsize. But then we need to decompress them before we can copy them to the GPU. So not only the decompression doesn't help us because it's full size again, we're also wasting time on loading. On the other hand, hardware accelerated textures like ASTC or DXT can just be copied as is. All you need to do is read the header and copy it. So not only you gain time on loading because you don't need to decompress them, you're also gaining your size again. Your runtime memory is smaller. And sometimes it's even smaller than PNG can do. It's lossy, but it's relatively good. Number 5, do not tolerate redundancy. You have your shader and you have your uniforms, and you need to do glget uniform location, my uniform name, and this is relatively slow. Oh, and if you're doing it on Dracul, not on init, go to your code now and fix it, put it on init. But what if we didn't need to do it? What if we could always know where our uniforms are? So with OpenGL ES 3.1, we can change the top shader to the bottom one. We always know where everything is. This is deterministic. Number 6, do not dismiss cool new technologies. With the Android extension pack, we have compute shaders and tessellation. We can use them for amazing level of detail or put in our physics in the GPU for higher performance. I have a video from ARM here. This is showing a 3D ASTC texture all on the GPU with compute shaders doing the particle physics. This is all on the GPU, nothing else. And you can expand it and use it for procedurally generated geometry like terrain and voxels. How amazing is that? Number 7, do not disrespect the hardware. Android is quite a new platform. But if we look at the performance for the past 4 years only, we can see the performance is more than doubling every year, and the child is going up and faster. Well, that's all.